So I have noticed a theme in conversations with friends, and many of you, including myself, seem to be living in a space of what's next. We all go through transitions, whether it be changing a job, your career, getting married, getting divorced, having a family, a parent's passing, a child going away to college. Those are just to name a few that I can think of right off the bat. Life changes, doesn't it? Situations change. It's constant. It's constant. We're always going through some sort of transition. The one thing we can be sure of every day is that life will change. So we have a choice. We can either accept it or we can resist it. It's really about perception, right? Sometimes we think, what is next? I can't wait. I'm so excited. And then other times we wake up and we say, oh, good God, what's next? Right? We've all been there. Thankfully, we get to choose what our attitude will be about our life. And we have to, are we looking at life as what is the next challenge going to be? Thinking of that challenge as something bad. Maybe we shouldn't be thinking of that challenge as something bad. Rather, think of it as our next life opportunity. Perhaps a better perspective would be, I don't know what good is in store for me today, but bring it on. I am ready. I can do this. I personally would like to approach life in that way. And I'm sorry to say, that doesn't always happen. I think that sometimes we just mundanely go from one life event to another, forgetting to be in gratitude for the experience that is being presented to us. So, what I would like to do is to encourage us all today for that not to be our truths, for us to not forget that every experience ultimately leads us to our highest good. I'll use the analogy of a caterpillar who goes through the metamorphosis of becoming a butterfly. I'm gonna guess that perhaps during that transition, that caterpillar may be thinking, oh man, this is so hard. Creating this cocoon, it takes so much energy. I can't do this. And then he's all smashed up in the cocoon and he can't go anywhere. And then he might be thinking, oh man, it's so cramped in here. And oh my God, I am so bored. Good God, what's next? But then, suddenly, when he accepts where he is in his silence, he feels a calling to break free of that cocoon that he, by the way, put himself in. Ooh, that was good. Don't we put ourselves in little cocoons, these temporary little prisons, so to speak? He knows instinctively what he has to do. That caterpillar takes on a new perspective and he begins to make his way out of that cocoon of his own creation. And the next thing that caterpillar knows, it's flying and it's free. And it's not just change, because there's a difference. It's transformed. Can never go back, and it's more beautiful than ever. So, even though that life transition didn't feel very good, it led that caterpillar to its true nature, its true calling, to its highest good. It has to become a brand new creature. We can do that too in our what's next. But I think the difference between us and the butterfly is that many times we can do the work to become the new creature, to become transformed, but then we slowly revert back to the old creature if we don't make a conscious effort to make good life choices. The choices that make us feel relief and help us to know that we are headed in the right direction, those are the good life choices. You feel that in your gut and your being. So remember this, after the struggle, after that life transition, you made it to the other side and you are now the beautiful butterfly. You are transformed. So why would you ever want to go back and try to live in a form that no longer fits you? Something that you are no longer. Sometimes it's easy to go back and do that. Ask anybody who struggles with addiction. So I leave you with that to think about and to ponder in your own life. Are you trying to go back to anything after a life transformation? Ask yourself the question, are you resisting a current transformation? Are you resisting what's next? Or just pondering what's next? And all of that's okay. So let's just take a moment and just breathe into that awareness. What's next? Take a deep breath in and let it out and notice the breath. Focus on your breath. Feel that relief upon that initial deep breath. And if you need to breathe in again and do it again, do so. And then relax and just allow your breath to easily flow in and flow out. Your breath is like life. There's an ebb and there's a flow. That's what our breath is, in and out. It's a natural cycle of life, expanding, contracting, evolving, changing, ever moving. You are being breathed in this moment as you allow your what's next to happen. As you surrender to your breath, you surrender to the life that is living you. So, and now focusing on the gentle inflow and the outflow and the rising and the falling of your chest and your tummy. There's absolutely nothing that you need to do. Just let go. Let go of the crazy from your week, because we've all probably had some of that. And as you breathe into what I like to think of as your heart space, I invite you to welcome the awareness of your divine nature, your divine light, whatever word or idea or phrase that connects you with that. It might be God, it might be spirit, it might be source. As you invite that in, you are opening your heart and your mind to the awareness that is beyond your normal way of being, your transformation, and thinking and speaking and hearing and see it. And seeing, I'm sorry. You're inviting the cohesion of that awareness to the connection of your soul, your higher being, your bright light, that higher self, that higher consciousness. And so as you allow it, as you imagine it in your awareness, and ask yourself this, what is that like for me? To be a new being, a new creature. What is it like to be in the world, seeing it from a new perspective, a new way of being, a better way of being? What is it like to rise above and to bring a higher consciousness, a higher energy vibration into my life? And in doing so, I can make a difference in others' lives. So as you invite the awareness of what's next, I encourage you to commit to accepting what is next for you, just as the caterpillar did. No matter what your definition of it is, maybe you view it as scary and bad, but it's not. It's simply another step to your highest good. And I encourage you to view your what's next as your highest good coming into physical form. So as we rest for a moment in the quiet, just welcome and invite that higher awareness into your body and into your mind. And like the caterpillar, you too are becoming the butterfly, free and beautiful, your own true divine nature. And take a deep breath in and feel the resonance of that energy and that vibration, and feel the hope and the love and the peace and the joy that comes with the connection of that breath with your true nature. And then in your awareness, be mindful that we don't have to say, oh God, what's next? We say, what's next? I am open and receptive to what is next in my life as this new being, this new way of being. I don't know what good is in store for me, but I am open to it now. I am open to experience and receive the good life has to give. I am. And after that statement, I am, fill it with what you resonate with. And note that is so. And that is what is next. Go be amazing.